Hi everyone, my name is Wally, I am 14 years old, and today I want to share the development story and engineering details of my first electronic model rocket, SamrukOne. A rocket I designed and built myself. This is the story of how my rocket failed, crashed, and finally flew successfully, and what I learned along the way. At first, I built this rocket for the Qatar Rockets Aerospace Tournament, which took place on 1st June 2025.
Technical task of my category was to create model rocket with a D-class motor, electronics that will show flight time and apogee on display, have a buzzer and recovery system that deployed by motor's ejection charge and land the rocket safely. I started from designing rocket in Fusion 360 and Open Rocket programs. To complete the task, I included microcontroller with display, atmospheric sensor, accelerometer gyroscope, microSD card module, and buzzer. To put it simply, it means rocket could record data and beep after landing. On the top of the rocket there are payload section and nose cone. Payload section keeps electronics and nose cone minimizes air drag. Then there is carbon fiber body tube, where I packed the parachute. At the bottom there are motor section, centering rings and fins from PLA. Fins stabilize the rocket and keep its flight vertical.
Then I started realizing everything I designed in real life.
I connected sensors with microcontroller and tested the electronics. Printed PLA plastic bars and connected them with glue. Calculated parachute's area and cut it from the polyethylene.
But I met some problems. For instance, microSD card module and display had conflicts. I didn't have enough time, so I made decision to remove my credit card module from the system and write data to the microcontroller's flash memory.
I thought everything was ready, but I forgot about one very important thing. I tested all rocket systems separately, however, I didn't do flight tests. That was a big mistake.
I felt very confident until my rocket smashed into the ground. When it crashed immediately, my heart just sank. I thought all my work was wasted.
Unfortunately, my rocket was simply too heavy.
In rocketry, there is a term called thrust to weight ratio, or TWR. TWR is ratio of rocket's thrust to its weight.
Mass of my rocket was 200 grams, while motor's average thrust is about 500 grams, which gives thrust to weight ratio about 2.
Sounds good, right? Only for large spacecrafts. But for model rockets it's actually too low. They need a much higher ratio, otherwise the wind just pushes them back to the ground. I realized it only after SamrukOne flight. Of course, I was disappointed, but I continued the project. I made a lot of constructive changes. Firstly, I simplified electronics part.
I kept only the microcontroller, atmospheric sensor, microSD card module, buzzer, battery and voltage converter.
Secondly, I placed motor section inside the body tube. And thirdly, used more powerful motor, E-class motor.
Do you think this version flew better? Well, not exactly. Rocket climbed high and ejection charge worked. However, the parachute lines couldn't withstand the load and broke. When it hit the ground, I felt terrible.
After that, I realized I should use stronger ropes for the recovery system. Next time I use ropes that are used in fishing and can withstand 30 kilograms load.
Unfortunately, I didn't have any more E-class motors, so I put D-class. The third launch was successful. Rocket climbed not very high, apogee was at 85 meters, but it at least landed safely. Electronics worked and I got data I needed. That felt like a huge success. Of course, when it finally worked, it was the best moment of whole project.
Through this video, I want to show that making mistakes is a normal part of any project. They are fuel of development. What really matters is to learn from them and gaining experience. This is the lesson SamrukOne taught me. So, if your project fails, don't give up. For me, SamrukOne was not just a rocket. It was proof that I can build something real with my own hands.